him home.
We usually take recess outside.
Right. See, it's math. I found this idea on the internet that you multiplications. You drill the ball, throw it back and forth. So.
Ah, good. Good. It's just it's a little noisy, you know, for the other classes without balls.
Oh, I understand. Yeah. We'll try to keep it down.
By the way, it looks interesting. Do you mind if I come by the next time you're doing the multiplication tables? I never thought I'd hear myself say that. But yeah, I would.
Yeah, absolutely. Sounds great. Okay. Who wants to be the octopus?
I mean, you'd think that they'd be interested in something new to get so bent out of shape by a little racket.
All our kids wanted to be in your class. You come in here all excited and bushy-tailed a year out of school. You may be ready to change the world, but to most people, different is a threat.
Yeah, but you're a great teacher. How can you be so cynical?
I save my enthusiasm for battles I can win.
Lorraine, hi. How are you?
Great. Couldn't be better. You?
Well, I got yelled at today because I was teaching math in this new way and...
What, are you kidding me?
I break up with the guy I'm supposed to marry, and you're the one having a tough day.
What happened? I thought you guys were gonna get married this summer.
Oh, well,
the bride's always the last to know. Last week's tabloids, you know what I mean? Excuse me.
Lorraine!
Yeah, I know. Look, we're going on our annual trip. You, me, and Steph. Only, we're not going in the summer, and we're going someplace fun. Spring break. A place called Mintners Cove or something. Somewhere near San Diego.
Get your life in order.
Wait, hold on. Our yearly trip now? No.
Yes. Hi. Steph's into it. In fact, it was her idea.
Find me another fiancé, at least for the week.
David and I haven't seen much of each other this semester, and we were gonna go on this camping trip.
What don't you understand about the beach?
You may not believe this, but I actually want to go camping with David.
Oh, you're farther gone than I thought.
I'll tell you what.
I'm going home tomorrow. I'll see him, and I'll ask him.
Ask him? Possibly.
Step 40 in. Let me tell you, you are in serious jeopardy.
Being dumped, she's gonna be a nutcase.
I don't know, Steph. You know, I've just been feeling a little weird.
A little unsettled lately.
It's our trip. Our little tradition. I know spring break isn't quite our thing. So what if you and Laurie are working? I'm still in school, so we qualify to go somewhere and act like idiots.
Well, you know what? Sometimes I wish I were still in school.
You are, just with a bunch of seven-year-olds.
We were together all those years in college, and we didn't have to worry about real life.
We're still friends. It's not as though I'm moving to China. At least not yet.
Although, maybe after spring break.
But see, that's what I mean. You're going to China and I'm here with a third grade and a bitchy principal.
You are so nuts. You know, I don't know who's worse. You or Laurie. I mean, here you are with a career that's actually working, about to be married to this great guy.
have those 1.8 fabulous children.
Well, I have to thrash my way through the academic jungle.
Yeah, but you're going to China.
Come on.
You have to come. It'll be great. You and David can spend your whole life going camping.
What are you doing home?
Checking to see who's leading him astray.
That doesn't take much.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Where is that bad boy?
Hey, Emma. He's working out, I think.
Okay, thank you. Okay, jigs up. Hide the girls.
Hey, Emma.
Hey, honey. Come and spot me.
Okay.
What the hell are you doing here?
Nice greeting. Spot me? What are you doing here? Can you get away?
I'm away. You are never getting up.
I think I'll make the rolls here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
God, when are you gonna get a decent bed?
When there's more call for it. We could probably figure out something to do about it, though.
Yeah, we could. But probably not this weekend.
Why not? You should live dangerously.
You better watch out. One of these days, you're gonna get stuck. Let's go. Got more important things to do.
Hey, I don't want to tell you over the phone, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this camping trip. I have to sit my advanced EMT course. It's the only time I can do it till next year.
You bum! Do you know that I just turned on a spring break trip with Steph and Lorraine to go camping with you, and now here you are dumping me?
Come on. Well, if I had my way, then we'd be so bored of being together all the time, and you'd be happy to have a break.
You think that?
What, that we should be together?
No, that we'd be bored.
Well, it looks innocent enough, but all that sun makes people a little crazy. You're better off where it's cooler.
How do you know, Dad?
I was in the Navy, remember?
Well, I'll stay away from anybody who's in a uniform. Except for maybe a fireman.
Dad's just worried once anybody leaves this suffocating town, they're gonna go crazy. Or never come back.
Yeah, Dad. Maybe we should find out what really went on out there.
That was before I met your mother.
Yeah, we've heard that before. All right, I better go. They'll forgive me anything if it involves Emma, but only up to a point.
I'll see you out.
What is this, an empty chair?
See you around, squirt.
Play hooky.
Oh, you want me to lug hose the rest of my life, is that it?
You're blowing my excuse not to go with the girls.
Well, you should go. It'll be fun, right?
Maybe. You have duty tonight?
Yeah, especially after this afternoon. Bye, baby.
I'll miss you. I'll bring you back a bronze goddess.
For 5 months.
All right. Well, looks like you get warmed up here. I'm never leaving.
Mintners Cove party girls?
That's us.
Hey, boy, have you come to the right place? How'd you girls get so smart you picked Mintners Cove? Look at that beach. And hey, we got a pool and we got a stage. You girls were born for that stage. We got a hypnotist, lets you do what you always wanted. Around here, I'm your man. Whatever you need, whatever you want, I'm your man. Hey, you like a different look? Just round the point, we got a different beach. Big waves, bars. Personally, I never leave right here. What do you got in these bags? Just bikinis? Here, give me that. Whew, all you guys are hot. We got lots of guys. Girls too, if that's your thing. Hey, you here to hook up? Cause I'm connected and connecting, you know what I mean?
Aren't you still in school? Like high school?
Yeah, well, we mature a little faster out here.
Oh, you got an older brother?
I am my older brother.
Oh, my God.
So many hot boys up in here. So many girls in their underwear.
Look, Kathleen. Remember when we were like this?
I was never like this.
I don't remember us ever being like this even when we were kids.
All they have is time. There's always gonna be, remember? We used to think there's always gonna be a guy, a career, and everything would just come naturally because that's what happens. There was plenty of time. Of course, we may never have met the guy or had the job, but we were gonna have it all. Get married, have kids, guaranteed. We're gonna be happy because we deserved it. Guaranteed. Well, time sure is a way of sneaking up on you. Nobody tells you it's a crapshoot where most people come up snake eyes.
I don't feel that way.
Yeah, you do. You do feel that way. You just haven't faced it yet. Otherwise, you would have married David long ago. I mean, what are you waiting for? David isn't turning to somebody else anytime soon. I mean, you walk into that firehouse, you know sure as hell what you get.
Knock it off, Lori.
I need to do something. Different. Have fun, you know? I mean, life is... Who knows what the hell life's about? Just found that out the hard way. And I need to be somebody who didn't just let it all get away. Whew. What I need is to hook up fast.
She is gonna get in a lot of trouble.
I know.
So many hot boys up in here. So many
look
girls
at her
in their underwear. Pull up to my mama, baby, don't be scared. I'm gonna give you a lap dance.
I'm gonna give you a chance
because I won't get ain't playing serious when I step in the club. Y'all know who it is. I get dough, I'm a baller, baby. BX, New York, shot caller, baby.
Oh my God.
So my neck keep me cool in the heat. Tipping me on my wrist, Jimmy Choo's on my feet. Guarantee.
Girls, where do you think you're going? Three most beautiful girls here and you're walking away? Did we do something wrong here?
Just a little reality break.
Reality? What is that? This is spring break. You gotta go a little wild. Otherwise, what's the point?
Are you guys watching a wet t-shirt contest? You guys have to do it.
No.
You know what you're missing? You know how it feels to have 100 crazy guys wanting to be with you?
Well, I've already got someone wanting to be with me.
But that's one pathetic guy. I'm talking about 100 crazy guys. Do you have any idea?
And another thing.
You know, like sexual charades, for example. You know, like that movie When Harry Met Sally. You seen that movie?
I've seen that movie, yes.
But right. Well, we'd be doing it in a hot tub, not in a stupid diet.
Who are you?
Hello, girls.
I thought we discouraged you.
Well, you must have mistaken me for someone who isn't falling in love. You girls have just won the Most Beautiful Girls Award. And we are the prize. So my two guys are gonna shoot your entire week. You'll never forget it.
I'm not sure I want to remember this week.
See, I thought I swore off these a minute ago.
You can swear off again tonight.
Oh.
this beach was special. Totally private. 5 minutes from your condo.
Oh my God, look at this.
It's so gorgeous.
This is just the beginning. Hey, I'm your ticket to a good life.
Got a sack full of backs on the side for the wheel. And if you mess with my dough, I'ma tie it to your lip. Put my foot on the gas, hit drive on the stick. Hit reverse on your body, put ties on your hip. Bet you thought I ain't seen that little line on your wrist. But I'm wise to them folk when they wide the stick. Flip 9 one time, got a dime for a hit. Certified gangsters and dimes in my clip. Sit red wine while we
shine. Look at that face. I knew it the moment I saw her.
Another body, dude.
Nuh-uh. Not just another body. Total innocence. But naughty.
She's not gonna do anything, not the type.
She will. Look, the right situation, the right drugs, the right booze. Besides, when we're done with this, she'll even think she did everything. To be Meg Ryan, right, Emma? Come on. Come on, baby. Do it for me. I know you can do it, baby.
Come on.
Come on, Emma.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh God. Oh. Oh my God. Oh God. Yeah. Oh my God. Oh yeah. 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 Right there. Right there. Oh God.
That was amazing.
I have a headache.
You need an aspirin? Yeah? You need anything else?
No, I just want aspirin.
There's a cabin downstairs. You want to come?
Yeah.
Come on.
I think I need an aspirin.
You sure you're all right?
any all of it?
Better if she were down a little. I got it. Perfect.
Say we're so proud of you. You're doing such a great job. And a few of the members of the board and the faculty want to discuss some ideas that we have for you next week. Okay.
Okay. That'd be great.
Yeah. I'm gonna get Grace involved.
I'm changing my vote from Girl of the Year to Teacher of the Year. I'm serious.
What the heck? Oh,
thank you, Rachel. It's all about the kids. I love you.
What the heck?
How did you get them to do all of that? I don't remember doing anything like that in the second grade except run around the playground. You think it's possible for me to be too impressed? I'm gonna give you a big head? You're gonna think you're too good for a small town fireman.
Oh, come on. I would love to show you how untrue that is.
You would?
Yeah. I would. Will you stay over?
Like I don't have a 4.5-hour drive to make my shift. But I'll be up next weekend, okay? I'm really, really proud of you.
I love you. In Mintners Cove, I really missed you. I wanted you to be there.
You're right. What about the hunk with the yacht?
I remember having a headache and playing charades. What do you think?
What do I think? I think you should go to San Diego more often.
You better go before I make you stay.
How'd you stop me?
You're kidding. By the way, I went topless one night.
I'm sorry, you what?
Yeah, we all did. It was a little weird out there. Should have been there. See the new me. I told you you didn't know what you were missing.
All over the country they come, and you know what they want. That girl next door, they play the tease, but they're showing it on display. They just want somebody to grab it. And you can be that guy and get them on the beach and in your lap. Get your credit card ready. Click the download button. Get every second of what these horny chicks do. No more hardened porno queens. These are the girls next door.
The board, we all were so impressed by your imagination and your handling of the children that the PTA would like to fund an extracurricular program for all grades.
Oh, my God.
For the other teachers as well.
I've had 3 kids go through this school. I thought you raised the bar. I thought you should be rewarded for your talents.
Wow, I don't know what to say. I'm flattered. I don't know quite how it would work.
Well, if you're agreeable, we could set up another meeting and see if we can figure something out.
Boy, you sure know how to make enemies. First you come back from California positively glowing, and now you're holding seminars.
It's a terrible idea, isn't it?
It's a great idea, but it's also the best way to get yourself most hated teacher of the year.
Well, then I just won't do it.
School politics are funny. I mean, it looks all touchy-feely, but you just never want to give anyone too much ammunition.
Get them on the beach and in
Hey, Jess, come here. Is that who it looks like?
Can't be.
It's like one of those spring break tapes, but it's different, more extreme. Did she go down to some spring break thing?
You watched the whole thing.
It's her. It gets pretty raunchy. You think we ought to tell Dave?
Suddenly all the other teachers are mad at me. Well, most.
Well, you could try switching schools. Better yet, you could come home. You know you could get a job in a second. Maybe it's time.
Is that code for get married and live happily ever after in Prairie du Chien?
So what if it is? It's not the end of the world.
I just don't know if I want to spend my whole life in a small town.
Why? What's wrong with it?
Well, would you live somewhere else?
I don't think so. I think Prairie has a lot to offer. I mean, history, family, roots. I mean, honey, it's a good town. It's our home. I mean, what, is there something you want to do that needs you to be someplace else?
It can be a little suffocating.
You don't think people feel suffocated no matter where they are? I mean, anywhere. Madison, Chicago, San Diego, wherever you were. All right, honey, I guess I could learn how to surf.
No, I didn't say that.
Look, all I'm saying is I don't remember you feeling this way before you took your little trip. Did something happen out there? Made you feel like you needed to be someplace else? I don't know, with someone else?
Listen, I've always felt this way. Okay, I mean, don't you feel this way sometimes? What if there's something out there that's perfect? Perfect for you, for us? You know, we might never know.
I think that everything that's perfect for us is right there. I mean, you could turn your back on it looking for something else, I don't know what, but by the time you figure it out, what you don't know is what you've lost.
David, nothing's changed.
Yeah, maybe. But at least it's in the open now. I mean, don't you think we've been ignoring this? You know, I'm not facing the facts
here.
What?
No. What are you talking about? Okay, listen. I love you, and you love me. Those are the facts.
Yeah, but, no, look, the fact is, I like Prairie, okay? I like my job. It makes me feel good. Like I'm doing something I'm proud of.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I've got to go.
Come here. I love you.
I'll see you soon.
I'm sure there's some kind of reasonable explanation here. Mistaken identity, something. I just thought you should know someone raised the issue.
I don't understand. If somebody would say something like that, don't I get a chance to defend myself?
It may be a little premature. If there's no substance to it, then we can forget we ever had this conversation. It's more important that it's not true.
What am I supposed to do? Somebody that I don't know who it is saying that I'm in some porno film that they won't identify, and And I what?
If you like to take the rest of the day off.
Oh, I wouldn't like to take the rest of the day off. I haven't done anything. Why should I? No.
Emma, it's not a suggestion. I'm not making it a formal suspension, but just take a couple of days off.
She wouldn't even tell me what they were talking about.
I heard it was about you in some movie. You didn't do anything weird when you were in San Diego, did you?
No. I mean, we all had fun. Well, we took our tops off one night.
That's it. Should have gone to Saint-Tropez.
I mean, sure, you let go a little. It was vacation. It was more silly than anything.
Yeah, but silly to you can be salacious to somebody else. I mean, the trouble with this kind of thing is there will always be somebody who believes it because they secretly want it to be true.
No, I haven't heard anything about it.
Yeah, I tried to call Rain, but I couldn't reach her. I've been suspended.
How can they do that? Are all of us in it?
I don't know. I don't even know if this thing exists. I mean, do you know where I would find this type of thing?
But I mean, what would we look for? Emma, Steph, and Lorraine, Flash, and Mintners Cove.
Okay, well, if you talk to Lorraine, tell her to call me, all right?
I will.
Okay, bye. All right.
Best M. Most S&M hits on the net. What's your wife doing while you're at work? Locker room.
Turn off.
I don't understand, Reverend. I thought we were doing a pretty good job for the church. Well, if you want to make a change, that's fine, but there has to be a reason. I mean, it's okay if you have to. I'm just confused. Look, if it's something we did, I have to go downstairs and tell Henry to cancel that Emmanuel Lutheran order.
St. Matthew's just canceled their bulletin order.
It makes three of our biggest accounts.
What's going on?
What the hell do you think you're talking about?
Look! Nobody is jumping to any conclusions.
Look, Dave, I'm sorry as hell, all right? We've all known Emerald online. Hey, all I did was stumble across something.
Hey, look,
what
Dave,
the hell, man?
Look, Dave, it's out there, okay?
What's out there? There's nothing out there. It's not Emma.
I live in these streets to see BTs on the covers, man. Crying in a trap of chips, you better find your muscle, man. I got me a friend and a
sad, doing time in the pen. Now I'm out doing mine on the grind for the chip. Got a sack full of backs on the side for the win. And if you mess with my dough, I'm tied to your lips. Put my gas in the
She doesn't have tenure. I mean, what is the policy in a situation like this?
But she has the right to bring it to the board. The school could be sued. Even the public airing of such an issue would be damaging to the school. It's also a human question.
Pretty soon, the kids are going to get wind of this and get curious. And I, for one, do not want to be explaining to my 7-year-old what pornography is. Now, I haven't said anything till now because she's such a good teacher. And she presents herself so well. But if she stays, I'm pulling Jason out of school.
Hi. You ought to check your machine. It rang about 1,000 times. Maybe it's not working. Anyway, you haven't answered my email yet. What's going on? Town burning down? manage pretty crappy here. Okay. Bye. I love you. Bye.
Your choice is either resign or I will have to take this to the district and initiate a formal dismissal. Now, if you resign, there can be some reason, something neutral, something that won't hurt your record. I'll help you frame the situation so it won't affect your future.
I didn't do anything. How could you believe that I would? I mean, at least let me talk to who's spreading this.
It's no longer a case of an unsubstantiated rumor. I have not seen the material. But others have, teachers, parents. I will look at it if I have to, as will the district.
What material? There is no material. I tried looking on the internet. You know, I don't have to accept this. I have a right to fight this, and I'm going to.
You do. You do have a right to fight this. But let me lay down the process. I fire you for cause. In this district, that is automatically reviewed by the superintendent and the board. Now, you can appeal at a district level, which will bring the whole sordid business into the public arena. But you should think very carefully about that before you do. Litigation, being what it is these days, it would have to be messy. And the district? It doesn't usually lose. Emma, I'm trying to do you a favor. If you fight it, it'll be on your record. Even if you're exonerated, even if it turns out to be nothing, it will be on your record. Every time you go for an interview, true or not, it'll be there. People, parents, will find out about it. They always do. Now, you think a school is going to go against parents in hiring a teacher? Believe me, I'm thinking of your welfare.
It is. It's not fair. I have to say goodbye to my children.
I don't think that's a good idea. There's a substitute already in place. Your things will be gathered and delivered to you.
How can you just have somebody disappear from their lives? You can't just yank somebody from them. You understand that?
They'll get over it.
Emma, wait!
Oh, Emma.
She wouldn't let me say goodbye to my children.
Look, I'll talk to them. I'll tell them something. Kids are resilient. They're usually more than we are. At least now we can go see a lawyer.
I'll resign. I agreed to leave.
Look, I know it's lousy, but... Well, sometimes it doesn't really matter whether it's true or not. I've got to get to class. Look, it's up to you. You've got to be strong. It's up to you.
stranger. Where have you been?
How are you?
What's the matter?
I'm pretty lousy, Emma.
I saw your film. Emma, I saw the video. Did you hear me?
I said I saw it. I saw you with my own eyes.
David, that puts you ahead of me because I didn't do any movie, okay?
And I refuse to look for it.
David!
It's called Girls Wilding Mintners Cove.
What are you thinking, Emma?
Were you drunk? Huh? Were you high? Then maybe I could understand what you... Were you having fun?
I can't deal with this, all right? I just can't.
This just means that I really don't know who you are.
David, will you please just listen to me for 1 second, okay? I didn't do any movie. I don't know what the hell is going on here. Just give me one chance, please.
Why don't you look at it on your computer? You can Google it.
Porn sites. Everywhere. Most of them.
I really thought I knew you, Emma.
David, just...
No. No, save it. I can't. I can't.
Printing.
Hi.
Emma. Hi. How are you?
I'm fine. How's everything there?
Oh, like always. Just chugging along. What's going on?
Hey, Dad. Do you miss Mom?
Every minute of every day.
I know.
What's wrong, baby?
God. I don't even know how to say this. I don't know what to do. I don't know how they made it or how it happened, but there's this tape and it looks like I'm on it, but I didn't do anything.
I don't know what to do.
What video? What do you mean?
I don't even know how to say this, but it's become some kind of nightmare. And the school, they think that I...
Honey, I'm not following you here. Tell me again.
No, it's okay. I can handle it.
Look, come home. We'll sort it out here.
No, it's okay. I'll deal with it.
All right, I'm coming up there.
No. Don't, Daddy, please. I'm fine. I'm fine. Oh, God. I have to figure this out on my own. I'll come home in a few days, okay?
Whenever you take this I can handle it attitude, it's like... Okay. Okay. All right, call me tomorrow.
There is a porno video with me in it. I saw it. You guys ruined a little, but they have me doing stuff with that guy. I mean, I'm not crazy, am I?
I mean, we were together the whole time, weren't we?
I wasn't drugged or something, was I?
We drank a lot. Wait, you mean like someone putting something in our drinks?
I don't know, Em. I mean, you realize you're sounding a little crazy now, right?
I'm not kidding. I got fired from my job.
Even I almost believe it's me right now. Do you remember that
charades game, faking the orgasm?
Yeah.
It really looks like I'm with that guy, Greg, or whatever his name was. I mean, it looks so real.
It's awful. It made me sick. David saw it.
God.
He won't even talk to me. I mean, and I can't blame him, you know? I can't.
What about Lori and me? Were we in it?
God, I mean...
A little bit. I don't know. I didn't watch the whole thing.
This could really hurt my career.
I mean, you know how academics are.
Look, come up and stay with me.
No, I can't. I have to figure things out. I mean, at least I can be a little anonymous here.
I just wanted to call, make sure I hadn't gone crazy.
You're not crazy. There must be some kind of a logical explanation for this.
Look, if you just come up here, it'll all be okay. I think we should stick together.
Emma, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Why don't you go take a run or something?
You know I'll come down there if you want me to.
It's okay. I'm fine. Thanks.
Well, that just sounds a little confusing.
I know. I know it does. But I know that I didn't do anything that's on that tape. But it looks so real. Even I almost believe it's me. I mean, what if I was drugged or something? You know, is that possible for me to do something like that and not even know it?
Well, one hears of cases of date rape, drugs, things like that. Look, Emma, there's a kind of bottom line. It may not be what you want to hear, but either you did it and don't remember, or you did some things that make it look like you're doing more, or it was somebody else.
You don't believe me.
I do. I do. Well, I want to believe you. I guess I do believe you because I trust my instinct about you as a person. But look at the situation. I mean, I haven't seen it. But even if you think about maybe being drugged or something, or whether you did it or not, people think you did. That's what you have to fight.
People see me and they think they know. They look at me and I can't stand it. Okay, I can't go anywhere without thinking that everybody knows. Do you know how that feels?
I called a friend, a lawyer. She wasn't very helpful. She had somebody in her office look at the videotape. Well, this is what she thought. She said it would be better if you moved away to some other school district. That thing's died down. With nothing on your permanent record, you could start afresh. Maybe it makes sense, Emma. Well, I'm your friend. I know you're a good person. You've proved that. A wonderful, talented person. But I'm not the issue. Even the school isn't. David is. Your family. You. You need to figure out something most people never have to figure out. Who you are and what you're gonna do about it.
I'm calling the police.
Oh, God.
It's okay.
I'm going home.
No, Emma. You can't let him get away with this.
You know, I just gotta get out of here.
You awake? You came home. I take it then it's not all good. I have an inkling about some of this. You haven't had much experience of bad things. So I don't want you to think you can't come to me, you know? Honey? That's good.
Is it? I stood there looking down some stupid plaque and thinking, where the hell is my mother? I guess it doesn't really matter anymore, but...
I'm home, Dad!
Hey, Em, what are you doing home?
Honey, could you give us a minute? We're talking.
Oh, what about Emma's dirty video?
I mean, I look at it this way. It doesn't seem like the kind of thing my big sister would do. But you could have had this Jekyll and Hyde moment. In that case, you're a very sick girl. If you didn't, maybe we should figure out what happened. I mean, can they do that stuff where you put your head on someone else's body? You know, like all that computer-generated stuff you see in the regular movies.
Do you remember that gag shot we did for the Kiwanis, where we mixed up all the heads with the bodies? But you'd have to have something to work with.
There was stuff I did. Like that charades game, but not anything like that.
We're all tarred with this. We've lost a third of our business. Almost all the churches.
Why don't you give Chief Rogers a call?
Look, I know you're having a rough time, okay? I mean, obviously you weren't treated that well by a couple of the cops up there, but...
One cop went as far as to say that it was my fault. I mean, here I am nearly raped, and they're telling me that I'm the type of person who's endangering women.
Emma, I would love to help you, but, well, all this is a little out of my league here. I mean, I don't think there are any federal laws that cover this sort of thing. This took place in California. God only knows what their laws allow.
So you're telling me that they can just get away with this? I mean, then what good are cops?
What if the police were to shut down that club, say, oh, to protect you from this happening? Now, I think you'd be pretty upset at the law missing in areas that most folks nowadays consider to be their own business.
Well, thanks for coming by, Chief. At least you listened. Hey, I've been trying to reach you.
Second private call.
Okay.
Yeah, I've been busy. I saw the tape. My first thought was, boy, she sure made better use of her time than I did.
Just kidding.
We were together the whole time.
Were we? Not like every minute. I mean, I was bossing Mr. Conga Line. Well, you have Mr. Wright.
What are you talking about?
Okay, I'm sorry you're getting a lot of flack for this, but, you know, people get Academy Awards for less. Or worse. Okay, the tape's pretty bad. And maybe it's not the Emma I know, but what other explanation is there? I mean, just forget it. Everybody needs to grow up a little.
Why are you doing this?
I'm just being honest.
My new mantra is to hell with it. I mean, the phoniness? I mean, who cares? Happens in Las Vegas, stays in Las Vegas, you know? I mean, everybody acts all shocked and then sneaks off their computers and watches it. Or swaps wives in Des Moines. I mean, have you seen what ordinary girls and those Girls Gone Wild tapes do? I mean, I'm doing stuff I wouldn't have done a couple months ago.
This is wrecking my life, and you're... what the hell are you doing?
Hello?
Dwight, there's a fire at the store.
Police think it was a couple of kids. They hear their parents talking and they act out.
Not a case of small town hysteria.
Maybe, but it's not as bad as it could have been.
Well, yeah, somebody could have been killed. On the other hand, we've been getting phone calls all morning. People expressing their sympathy. We even got a couple of accounts back.
Sure you want to be here? I mean, last night was pretty emotional. You don't want to get stuck just because you rescued some poster.
Excuse me.
I know what I'm doing.
Do you? Did you know what you were doing when you weren't around when I needed you?
What?
Look, I don't blame you. Or maybe I do. You know, I don't know what I would have done with somebody that I loved. But all I know is that I've been through hell. And nobody protected me.
Look, we're not back yet. I don't know if we're gonna get there. We could talk about you feeling unprotected, but there is a lot of other stuff here. Like you not wanting to marry me, or giving me the idea that you wanted to explore other options.
Whoa, I never said that.
Yeah, no, the hell you didn't, okay? But that's how I took it. Maybe there's some Dr. Phil way I should have reacted. I'm operating on blind faith here. Like, what the hell actually did happen out there? Why didn't you just come and tell me everything? I think I just deserve a little credit for that.
Maybe you do.
Look, maybe we can get through this. Maybe we can't. Either way, Emma, I want you to know I'm here to help. Let me help. Okay, assuming she didn't do what's on the tape, then what's the explanation?
Well, usually these videos are just regular college girls. They get drunk and lose it. I mean, they have sex and stuff, but this is like far more hardcore. Also, the style.
Wait, I don't follow.
Well, it jumps around a lot. Something weird. Maybe you get someone to analyze it or something.
Hey, does your brother know if there's some sort of
department or research program that
can tell if something like a video is real or not?
I'm sure there must be something.
Maybe the communications department can set up a test.
Are you nervous? Liar! You're afraid that the video might prove that I did what it really looks like.
You're afraid if it doesn't, then you're gonna have to stay mad at me forever. I don't know. I think we're both gonna have to grow up on this one. I mean, the question is, do you prove to someone that you love them by standing by them no matter what it looked like they did? Or do you forgive somebody for being confused about it? This is a no-win situation.
Who's the you?
Me. You.
Well, it sounds like we're stuck.
I love you. That's what I know. More than anything, I just wish I could understand it a little better.
What if I was drugged or psychotic or something?
Psychotic? I never bargained for psychotic.
This is a very good job, you know. This one looks like the face and the body are the same. Excellent. Now, if I magnify the image more and more to here, you can see that there is a shape difference between the pixels on this side of the line and the other side. And if I had density, see? The images were taken in different light. The other thing is this, the movement of the pixels. One really must admire the work here. This difference in the speed of the movement is virtually undetectable.
So it's not me?
Well, some of it is you. And the top part is you. The bottom, oh, the rest, appear to be someone else.
It's fake.
It is a fake.
Oh my God, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You see? This is me. Remember, I don't need any help. You'd testify, wouldn't you?
That is the question. And the answer is, of course he is. But the defense, what will they do? They'll get some other version of me to prove the exact opposite.
Yeah, but the tape is fake.
Oh, yes. But do you really expect the jury to sort it out? When the most convincing expert is always the last one to speak.
I have to do something about this.
There is someone to whom I have consulted, specialist in privacy law. I could give her a call.
I would say you have a pretty clear case of identity theft. On the other, to a certain extent, you're damaged goods.
Excuse me, but what the hell do you mean by that?
The defense would contend that at the very least, you voluntarily put yourself in a position, appearing in a public display that allowed them to use your tape, even acting out a sexual simulation. There's no chivalry in these things.
I was fired from my job, stalked, nearly raped, my family's business burned down to the ground. Me and everybody that I know has been humiliated, and what if this never goes away?
You might be able to convince a jury that you've been slandered on the identity theft issue, but if you're not a public person, you know, the damage to your reputation is usually considered minimal. You'd be amazed how common what you're experiencing is. In one form or another.
So you mean to tell me that a lot of women are having their heads put on another body and being turned into porno stars?
Oh, you're a little unique. But there are a large number of women who go someplace, like you did. Well, say spring break, or Mardi Gras, or even on their college campus. And they do something like flash their breasts or get drunk, even allowing themselves to be photographed having an orgy.
But I didn't do anything like that.
Yeah, but you also didn't exclude yourself. The explosion of pornography and technology affects all women. And whether it's what happened to you or somebody with a cell phone or a miniature camera in a girl's locker room, basically, it undermines a woman's right to do or be whomever she wants to. It was far simpler when we're more puritanical.
That's just nuts.
Yeah, well, it is schizophrenic, but look at our culture. A lot of it women have either helped create or patronized. We have rap lyrics which degrade and invite abuse of women, which many women approve of. Advertising is filled with self-porn. A culture is full of images which are designed to sexually excite. Now, the man who stalked you probably thought you were just playing hard to get. College girls line up to do soft and hardcore for the fun of it. It's big problems for juries. Yeah, how many contradictions can they deal with?
Yeah, but I thought that there were laws protecting women.
No, there are and there aren't. Well, women are mostly protected by commonly understood social contracts. In the last 30 years, we thought we could have it all. Independence and protections.
There's got to be something that can be done.
Most laws are a generation behind the technology. Now, the Supreme Court of Washington State ruled that a woman was not protected in a checkout line from an up-the-skirt camera. Other state courts have held that women are not protected in their own bedroom or bathroom against photography through an open window.
But people sue for everything all the time.
Well, that depends how much time and money you have. And how much humiliation you want to endure.
Let it blow over. I mean, the bigger deal you make of it, the worse it's going to be for all of us.
Yeah, but it isn't a secret. I get looks everywhere I go. I don't want those looks. I don't want people looking at me. You know? And if I just let it go, then thousands, maybe millions of people will think that I did it.
Yeah, but you'll never know those millions of people. They might as well not exist for all the influence they'll have in your life.
The trouble is that if I leave Prairie, I mean, look at Minneapolis. A lawyer there said that I would be better off just leaving the city. I mean, that video is everywhere. All over the internet, in stores. You know, maybe it's impossible. And all I want is for people to look at me the way that they used to. David.
Honey. Give it up.
Damage control in a case like this is just to surround yourself with the people who love you. David, your family, me. You're cool for another teaching job. Just lay low. Be anonymous until this whole thing disappears. We'll protect you.
I'm going to Mintners Cove. I have to know.
You know what? You know already. You took your top off, you played some stupid game, and they made a porn video out of it.
It's dangerous. If these people are capable of doing what they're doing, then God knows what else is going on out there.
They took something from me, and I need to get it back.
Well, I'm going with you.
No, you're not. That's the problem. I can't be a child who needs someone to ride her bike with her when she goes down the street. I can't be. When that guy in Minneapolis stalked me and then attacked me, I let him. I mean, I was so afraid that I gave up. I gave myself up. And if it hadn't been for Alice, it's still with me. And I can't let this hang over me. I have to do something about it, because if I don't, then I'm always gonna be afraid.
Pathetic in daylight.
Excuse me? Hey, you know a guy named Greg or Jimmy? Still in high school? I need to find them.
No, you don't. You need to go home and get over it.
No, see, you don't understand.
You don't understand. I stand behind this bar watching this parade of you girls go through here. What do you think? The world's set up for you? It's a setup, all right. But this isn't your world. You can't get even with it. You can't win. Best you can do? Be glad you survived. There are a lot of girls out there who didn't. Believe me.
She gave me the number of a lawyer who handles cases like this, but they wouldn't give me an appointment. She said he'd be in court. He'd be gone for 3 weeks. God, LA is so huge. I mean, I don't quite know how to do anything.
Okay, go to the courthouse. Find out which one. In LA, there's probably a lot he could be in, but all the trials are posted. I'll call and see if Professor Richardson can give him a call, okay?
How'd you get to be so smart?
Maybe there's a lot of things you don't know about me.
Not too much, if you know what I mean. Excuse me, Mr. Salkin, could I please talk to you for a moment?
No.
My name is Emma Norman. If I could just... Damn it, please?
I told Professor Richardson I wasn't interested.
Just 5 minutes.
All right, go. What do you want?
Excuse me?
You want money? Someone to go to jail? You want to close down a production house? A hotel? You want your reputation back? A public apology? Come back when you know. I've got to be somewhere. Look, in California, there are no good criminal remedies. There's a few civil codes we could pursue, but I've had my head handed to me on this kind of thing. You think in our litigious world where you can get millions from being within a block of someone smoking, or an asbestos judgment from a jury without being sick, that someone who's truly damaged would actually have a chance. But you'd be wrong.
But what about libel or slander laws or fraud? I looked up on the internet the privacy laws of California.
Privacy law is very new and very subjective. There's no historical precedent for it in tort law. As a matter of fact, it changes all the time. Privacy is what 12 men and women think it is. I've won some privacy cases, from paparazzi after stars to unauthorized books and movies. But every time I go after one of these guys who distributes soft or hardcore porn, I've lost. Juries find it very difficult sorting out our First Amendment rights and our privacy rights.
They put my head on another body.
That is actionable if you can prove that the distributor ordered it or even knew about it. I know from Professor Richardson that you have a technical expert who's going to testify. The company will have five. You participated in some stuff, right? That means that the jury has to figure out what was voluntary and what wasn't. That makes it look like everything was voluntary. Did they hold a gun to your head? Listen, juries are as culturally conflicted as the rest of us. High divorce rate, infidelity, ordinary housewife swinging. People who get on juries range from people who watch porn, who are in porn, who are intensely moralistic. Do you sleep with your boyfriend? Did you kiss the guy in the conga line? You were fired from your job. That means somebody thought you were complicit. The defense will tear you apart.
Hi, does your company produce those spring break videos?
Do you know who does?
Hi.
Be here to shoot someone or get a job?
I want to talk to someone in charge.
Must want a job. Mintners Cove's second edition is here to see Nick. Most of the films are shot on location. What we do here are mostly retakes, close shots, and inserts.
I am so glad to finally meet you. Emma, isn't it? It was on the ID security gap from your bag. I assume that's your real name. You are so good. I mean, I see a lot of girls, and you're special. You'd be surprised. It's in the face more than the body, and you just jump off the screen. It's really something. I mean, I had no right. I see lots of girls. A lot of girls.
Here is the new cover. You are gonna be a star.
I just wanna know why you doctored that tape.
Sorry?
You juxtaposed my face with somebody doing things that I never did.
You're kidding, right?
No, I'm not kidding. Look at the tape.
Look, I'll admit maybe we did a little bit of that when we first started, but now, hell, we make so much money from legit movies we make here or acquire, we don't have to. We even get releases. Today, girls will do damn near anything for a couple of bucks.
No, I never signed a release, and I never did anything that's on that tape.
You're not kidding.
Of course I'm not kidding.
That SOB. Con me. Well, Greg, he said it was a real deal, that you were the real deal. Well, he did a damn good job.
I want you to take that tape out of circulation. You have to recall it.
You gotta be nuts. Look, I'm sorry you got screwed. Excuse the pun. But we're talking about a very successful video here. This is a big seller. We could break a record with this one.
I can talk to the police. I've already talked to a lawyer.
I hope it was sulking. I've beaten him so many times, he might as well work for me. And you've probably already been to the police. Not much help, are they? I'm the First Amendment man. Hey, look. Tell you what. How about $10,000. You deserve it. Think of this as a down payment. Too bad. Well, there's always another one that comes along.
Where's Greg?
Are you really this dumb? You don't have any idea what you're dealing with. This is a big city. I'm the nicest guy you'll meet in this town. Greg, he's a wild card. I buy stuff from him when he shows up, that's all. If I knew where he lived, I wouldn't tell you. I wouldn't want it on my conscience.
Conscience?
Go home. It'll be over soon.
Audience gets bored fast. You know what they're into now? Fake rape.
You've got a short shelf life. In fact, I got someone newer and hotter downstairs right now.
You are bound and determined to get yourself into trouble, aren't you?
I really need to get this. Please, please, will you help me?
It's not helping you, believe me.
Hey, what can I do for you?
You don't remember me?
No, I meet a lot of pretty girls, but I don't.
Mintners Cove? You made a porno movie with my face?
Oh, yeah. How'd you find me?
Nick Bronson.
Well, look, if you want some money, I didn't make a dime from that tape, okay? You gotta talk to him. He's the one that makes all the money.
I don't want any money.
Look, I'm sorry. It's nothing personal, okay? It's business, all right? That's it.
That isn't it.
Well, look, I'm not gonna talk out here, so...
So this is it. Guess where you made it?
What are you gonna do? You gonna arrest me? You gonna call the cops? You know what? I do remember you. That tape rocks because of you. Otherwise, it's just another body screwing.
So that's it, huh? That's why you used me.
Why else? What? It ruined your life? You gonna call some lawyers and try to sue me? For what? For cheating? For lying? For stealing your soul? What, your boyfriend dumped you? Your friends laugh at you? They're jealous.
You really just don't get it, do you?
No, it's you that doesn't get it. You want a perfect life, all neat and orderly? You stay in Kansas. That night, you wanted it. You were on. You really wanted it. You know, I could do anything to you. I could even rape you. And nobody would believe you.
Thank you.
You're pathetic. Is that what you do? Is that what you're trying to tell me, that you're gonna rape me? That's it? That's your life, making phony tapes. You know, I don't know why I was ever scared of you.
It's my computer!
You know what?
What?
I almost feel sorry for you.
I'm gonna kill you!
Stop! This isn't real? This isn't real sex? Look at this! It's absurd! You? I was afraid of you? What was I thinking? It's strange. I've never felt more afraid, degraded, humiliated. But somehow, I feel exhilarated. I know now that the only thing that frees you from fear is your own power. There are no protected places. The internet is in big cities and small towns. Pornography is changing the way women have to live. You may not think it has anything to do with you, but it is everywhere. If I could tell my story, if other women and girls knew what had happened to me, they could realize no one controls your honor but you. I don't need anyone to give me back my honor. I never lost it.